This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at CR College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to use differential analysis to make important decisions within companies. Differential analysis, and it's often, by the way, called incremental analysis. Differential or incremental revenues and costs represent the difference in revenues and costs between two different courses of action. And I'm going to show you on the next slide what this typically looks like. But we're looking at alternatives and trying to figure out which alternative is best for the company. It's often used to make the following types of decisions that you see here. For example, we might want to decide on whether to make a product internally or to buy it from the outside. That's often called outsourcing. Maybe we want to have somebody outsource the production of our products, or perhaps we would prefer to make them internally. We want to assess the costs that are differential to each of those alternatives. Some companies also want to take a look at whether to keep product lines or to drop product lines. So, for example, we could be a hardware store and we carry an outdoor furniture product line and we carry a plumbing product line. And we can look at those product lines to see if it makes sense to keep both of them or perhaps to drop one of those product lines. Thirdly, we might want to decide on keeping or dropping customers. It may be that we have some customers that we're not sure if they're profitable or not, and we want to assess that. And there might be some customers that we determine to be unprofitable, in which case we may choose to drop that customer. So that's another way to use differential analysis. And then lastly, we may get some special orders from customers, and we have to decide, does it make sense to take those special orders on or to reject those special orders? Each of these types of decisions is discussed much more thoroughly in separate YouTube lectures that I've created. So if you want to see the details of what this analysis looks like, take a look at those separate videos. Here we're just looking at, in general, what differential analysis is all about. So what does the format look like in performing differential analysis? This is a fairly good generic example of the format that is often used by companies that are performing differential analysis. So this example here relates to a decision about whether to keep or drop unprofitable customers. And we essentially have two different alternatives. Here's alternative one, and alternative one is to keep all our current customers. And then the second alternative is to drop any unprofitable customers that we might have. And we're not sure. I know it says that it's unprofitable here, but we aren't certain that dropping what we think are unprofitable customers is actually the best approach for us. And again, I talk about this in much more detail in a separate video. But this is the general format of differential analysis. And then the third column shows the actual differential amount between each of these two alternatives. And the last column shows us whether alternative one, in this example, keeping all customers, whether alternative one is higher in terms of sales revenue over here, higher in terms of variable costs and contribution margin, fixed cost, and actually what we'll see here is alternative one is lower in profit. So this is the format that we typically use, and you'll notice that we're looking at a contribution margin income statement format here. And I have a separate video on what that is all about, so you can take a look at that video if you're not sure about what we mean by contribution margin income statement. In any case, we're looking at each of these alternatives, alternative one and alternative two, and the profit associated with each. And you'll notice that alternative one has profit of $1,300,000, and alternative two has profit of $1,320,000. And therefore, alternative two is the best. Alternative one has lower profit by $20,000, so we prefer alternative two. Again, take a look at the videos that show this type of an analysis in detail. This is just to give you a sense of what differential analysis looks like.